Hey everybody, welcome back to my Ranch Simulator playthrough, and in our last episode we built our park processing building that connects to our barn. And I just wanted to give you guys an update, and I think I've got this figured out. We have minimized the deaths. As you can see, we have a lot of females in here. I think this might be a male, but I can never tell for sure, so we'll find out later. But basically, right now, things are looking good in here. This is all the pigs that are kind of just living over here and getting ready. This is a female pig. So I'm assuming this size right here is probably what this was a couple of days ago. I've got a really good suggestion for the developers, and I don't know why it isn't implemented in the game. We can see these stats. We can see when a female is pregnant, there'll be a pacifier. And as a matter of fact, right there, you can see the pacifier. My question is, why can't there be the male-female symbol to identify these pigs? Look at this is a little pig, and it's pregnant. How can that be? Anyway, welcome back, everybody. It's crazy. This was the hardest thing to do, is get the pig situation settled down. So, okay, they've got a silo and food over there. And here's the guys that help keep this ranch running right here. These are the slaughter. We've got our first slaughter. They're ready to go. They're nice and fat. So let's get to the slaughter part. This is the stun gun. Let's see how this works. Hello. Don't mind me. I'm just here to murder you. Aww. All right. No. I don't want to manage him. Now what do I do? How do I... Oh, pull the trigger. Gotcha. Well, get over here. What's going on here? Why isn't that working? Press to pull trigger. All right. Oh. Is that it? No? All right. Not that. All right. So this is how I would assume you would do it. Right in the head here. Manage. All right. Now can I press the trigger? Nope. Aim. There. Okay. That put him down. They're not happy. Look. Yeah, I know, guys. This probably isn't going to be fun for you. All right. And pull the trigger. There. All right. So you got to be right over their head. Get right in front of you. There we go. Where are you? There you go. Lay down. Go sleepy. Come here. I've got some sleep tonic for you. There you go. All right. Let me get these guys slaughtered. And then we'll pick up the meat and we will sell the meat, make a profit on the meat. And I want to grab some stuff in this episode to start another greenhouse run. I don't have any plants in there. I want to get some plants in there. So I think we'll buy some more grapes. I'm going to get all of this meat picked up. This is a good design, though, for this building, because we can drive in it. Do everything we need to do. All right, I'm going to get this meat picked up. We're going to go to the store. Before I pick the meat up, let's talk about something here. What I'm doing, give us a little test. How much more is it worth going through all the hassle of processing the meat. And, you know, should you just raise the pigs, kill the pigs, cooler the meat, drive the meat over to the burger place, sell it, be done with it, move on? Or is it worth, you know, as a solo play, going through all of this? We're also going to pick up some water while I'm there, because I want to show you something. We can actually put water in this pan and then put this pan on here and drop one of these in there and boil it. So I thought we might do that in this episode as well. See what that's all about. Got 24 pork sausage with egg. And I've got without egg 18, and I got six. There we go. They're done. So we've got 24 without egg to compare with the egg. You know, just see what the price is. See how that, you know, see how the pricing works. Is it even worth it? What, you know, over a full cooler of straight up meat versus coolers of processed meat. We've got some salami in here that we're cooking up here. Salami meatballs. Oh, these are done as well. So yeah, we can take these out of here now and put them in here. And now we have, you know, a couple of different products. I got 22 salami. All right. Do I have any more salami? I do. Okay, we can do a full cooler. What's a full cooler of the salami worth? What's a full cooler of pork sausage salami and pork sausage with the egg salami, where we added the egg to make them? And I think this is just overflow. Yeah, this is just overflow. No, actually, I did pork meatballs with eggs. So you know what we'll do? Because it's not that hard. We'll fill that up with the egg salami pork meatball versus the pork meatball without the egg. Basically just getting a rough comparison on the eggs. What have I got in here? Anything? Nope. Okay. Real quick. Four curing cabinets. They hold six. So that's 24. 24 in a cooler. I think you get where the math is going. As you know, I try to put a little efficiency into the build as possible. You know, put some efficiency, not a as little. I misspoke. I try to put a little efficiency into the building. So here's a little bit of efficiency. I would go with four of these because you'll have 24 when it's said and done. So that'll fill a cooler. Let's get the rest of this up. All right, so the net was, let's see here. We got 7 full coolers, and this is not quite full. It's only got 13. And let's see if our pigs are asleep. Our pigs are asleep. All right, so here's where I would search. Now, this is where I would like the developers to put male-female designation. Okay, obviously a female. But I brought one over that was not showing at this stage to be a female. And when I got it over there, it became a female. I don't know. Anyway, like this one. Is this a female? This to me looks like a male. So what I would do is say, come on, bud. I got a new home for you. So as a solo play, I think this is the easiest way to deal with these guys. They're all sleeping. They're not going to be following me. I can leave the gate open. And if you set your night for 30 minutes... You know, it gives you plenty of time to do just this. Come on in here and let's hope you're a boy. Close off the gate. And there we go. Look at that. As simple as can be. provided that's a male. And again, I think the game is fantastic. I love this game. I can't tell you enough. This is, I just want it to be good. Now this looks like it might be a male. He looks plump. He's getting the jowl, but the females get the jowls too. So this guy's running. Yeah. Let me get in the slaughter pen. Hey, no, pal, not in my house. No animal. Oh, come on. No animals allowed in my house. That's not my house, but it's my work area. I don't want pig poop in there. Got enough pig poop. Stay in there. So this is basically, you see what I'm doing here. You get the theory, right? I don't have to do this all night tonight. Again, this guy looks like a, this looks like a, I can't, you know, when do the females develop their, now here's one. Okay. It's the same size. Help me out here, folks. If you know, if I'm missing something, drop a comment. RP, you're missing something. Here's how you tell. I can't tell. As far as I know right now, you can't tell. I would love a surprise for somebody to say, hey, you know, actually, this is how you tell. I mean, that'd be great. Come on. This will be the last one, and then we'll get, hey, I got a friend for you. There you go. And this is what I would do. See, because they can eat here. They can live. They can eat. If they're males, they're just going to get fat. And you get what's happening. We can expand later. We can expand right around the silo. Fence it out here. Give a little more breathing room if it's necessary. So it's expandable. But again, you're playing by yourself. This is if you were playing by yourself. How are you going to deal with all this? You know, you've got chickens to deal with, by the way. I've got a ton of chickens. Not a ton of chickens, but I mean, that's doing well. I've got a lot of chicken eggs. Got to deal with that. You're over there dealing with the chicken eggs. The silo goes empty. You don't catch it. And the pigs die in 5 seconds, which is not that they should adjust that. This is my what the game needs to be. What needs to be fixed in the game. Pigs don't die if they miss a meal on the 30th. They don't die on the 31st. So give us a little breathing room to catch our feeder. If we don't get NPC play, right? If you can't hire somebody and then assign them to feeding, then at least adjust the pigs so that they don't die the minute the feeder runs out, and you've got a whole barn of dead pigs. Let's grab some sleep, get some daylight going here. I want to go to the market, and I want to get some comparisons done. So I think we'll just go with the pork sausage and this is all of our meat. Go with the pork sausage. See how much that's worth. And we'll go with the other ones here. What else have we got? We've got the pork meatball with egg. Probably not gonna do that. I don't think that's gonna make much of a difference. Let's do the one without. All right. And do that one. There. That pork meatball salami 24. Okay, good. And let's grab the last one. This one. I'm going to buy a water when we get there because I want to come back and boil a sausage, right? Aren't you excited? I know I am. Who wouldn't want boiled sausage? All right, let's get in here. Take a look at what we got. Now, there's a multiplier here that I've been told about. I don't know how you see the multiplier, but anyway, here's the deal. The meat on its own is $720 a cooler. You process it into pork meatball salami, and it brings it up to $960 a cooler. Holy cow. Hold on here. Are you holy. Okay, folks, look at that. Pork sausage with egg, one cooler is $3,000. Yeah, we are going to be making pork sausage with egg at $3,000 a cooler. That, yeah, I will definitely put the time in to do like four full coolers, depending on how fast the curing process is. So that's awesome. Okay, without the egg, it's $2,592. I'm gonna go with the egg, and the only reason is I got a lot of eggs. What am I gonna do with them? I might as well put them in here, right? Put them in the pork. That's fantastic. All right, let's go ahead and sell all of this because we're back in the money. Excellent. Let's take a look at our money. There it is, folks. $20,729.35. Yeah, I'm whistling a tune of profit. Thanks so much for joining me, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the episode, and we will see you in the next one, where I think we're going to go bee hunting. I think I want to try and find a bee's nest somewhere amongst the trees and see what honey production is all about. So until the next episode, ta-ta, bye-bye, and happy ranching.